1990X. Confidentially developed battleship Skeleton Crew is about to snarl at secretly on the Atlantic Ocean. Who can stop the ambition of crazy scientist Dr. D? The time came. Let the world know your great power. Give fear of death to pity human.
You shall go.
Big Fight.
Big Fight, or as its full title calls it, Big Fight, Big Trouble in the Atlantic Ocean, is a side-scrolling beat-em-up developed and published by a company called Tatsumi in 1992. In Big Fight, it is your mission to stop the nefarious Dr. D, and you can do so by going it alone or having a friend join in for some co-op fun. Now, beat-em-ups are pretty simple in design. You got your typical characters, with one being fast, one being strong, and another one who is the balance character. Usually each player has a different throwing move and their attack animation is different, but that's about it. Yet some games go beyond this simple system and implement special moves that you can pull off by doing a quarter circle down attack or something along those lines. Big Fight is one of those games, as it gives each character two special moves that you can perform with some sort of input combination. That isn't the only unique feature with Big Fight. You also have something called Anger Power. You see, whenever you get knocked down, you have the chance to make your character stronger by mashing the attack button as quickly as possible, in hopes to fill up the anger meter seen here. Once you fill it up, your character is able to move faster, do more damage, and even increase his attack reach by just a bit. Naturally, this state will wear off after a while, but it is a unique and useful feature, especially during boss fights. Yet Big Fight doesn't stop there. The most unique feature in my eyes is the ability of unlocking additional characters. While you start off with just three to choose from, there are five additional characters that you're able to add to your team. This is done by beating each stage's boss. Once you defeat them, they will mention that they have now come to their senses and will ask you if they can join your team of badasses. Or, as the game puts it, taking them into partnership. Because you just gotta love those translations. Whenever you beat a stage and acquire a new team member, you are actually able to switch your character before heading to the next area, which is genius because who wouldn't want to try out a new character as soon as they unlock them, right? So good stuff there. Then there's also the addition of a versus game mode. If you so please, you can challenge your friends to a big fight where you can choose any of the playable characters to fight against each other in a best 2 out of 3 match. This is something I haven't seen much in arcade games. Sure, it doesn't play as well as Street Fighter does, but it's still a cool feature to add to a beat-em-up game if you ask me. And now, having covered all that, let's dig in and check out the graphics. And I'll warn you right now that this game is a bit glitchy. I'm guessing there must have been some issue during the dumping process. I won't count these glitches against the game, of course, because I'm not a savage. So right off the bat, I have to compliment the game's scenery. I mean, just look at this screen. The boat is constantly in motion. The city in the background is animated and reflected in the water, which is also constantly moving. The moon is moving along, thus giving you the feel of motion, and then you have this nicely animated chain in the foreground. This scene right here is awesome, but the good thing about this game is it doesn't blow its whole load on just the first screen. Every stage is filled with foreground and background images and animations, which makes the eye wander and never get tired of looking at the screen. Sure, some assets are used multiple times, but heck, what game doesn't do that? But it isn't all roses and sunshine when it comes to graphics, because the character design is the one thing that made me shake my head at times. Big Fight has a certain character style that's sort of fine, really, but there's some characters that are just so out of place. like these super buff guys. They are way too huge. Like, they seem like they don't belong here at all. But my favorite has to be this guy, the flippin' Pharaoh. Looking past the fact that he is super tall and that they misspelled his name, check out his swag walking animation. Let me just make this statement loud and clear. Jersey's here. Some dudes got problems with me over there. That has got to be the greatest thing I've ever seen in a video game. And you have to remember, somebody animated this, showed it to their boss, and they said,
"Yep, that looks fine. Put it in the game."
Game development. Just amazing. But when it comes down to it, I can't really complain about the character style. While I did dislike it at first, it kind of grew on me, basically because there's plenty of beat-em-ups that are just way too normal looking, where the biggest change in detail from enemies is this guy is wearing a trench coat and, I don't know, this guy's wearing a hat. Having characters that seem kind of weird just makes it stand out, and that is a big plus in my book. So all in all, the graphics get 9 points. Up next, I want to address the audio, which I'll keep rather short because there's not much I can say about it, sadly. The sound effects are your standard beat-em-up sounds, you know, slashing and connecting punches, and the music is there and does its job, but it's not really worth commenting on as it has no real impact on the player. This is a common issue I have with beat-em-ups because I just feel that music can add so much more to a game, and this should especially go for beat-em-ups. A hectic soundtrack for boss fights can just add so much flavor to the game. When I'm thinking about music and beat-em-up games on the arcade, the first song that always comes to mind is the first stage song of Final Fight. That tinny and rough sound you get just stuck with me as a kid, and even today I can recall it immediately. And that's what I mean, you need something that will pull you back into that game, into that mindset of playing it, that'll just stick, and sadly you don't get this here. So while the sound effects and the music is very standard, there's nothing memorable. So 5 points. The next subject to talk about are the controls. The layout is as simple as can be. 2 buttons, A to attack and B to jump. Press both together to trigger a roundhouse attack that damages your foes and yourself. As I mentioned before, each character has special moves it can perform. Most of them require you to do a half circle punch or a dash and punch. Thankfully, the game actually shows you on the demo screen what character can do what moves. So if you're planning to use specials and don't want to figure them out yourself, I suggest to let the demo screen run for a bit. I should also mention that you can perform a block by hitting A and then swiftly following that up by hitting the direction opposite of which your character is facing. And that pretty much covers all the controls. Very simple and responsive. 10 points for me. And seeing as I just mentioned the block, let's talk about the learning curve. Blocking might be useful in this game, and I say might because I figured out how to block after I beat the game. Actually, I'd say it becomes an essential thing because the difficulty becomes pretty rough once you pass stage 3. Enemies are able to take some major damage while you sometimes may feel like a plate of glass. As an example, I ask you to take a look at this. This buff guy just wasted a whole life of mine with one grab. I was jamming all the buttons like crazy, but couldn't escape. This just seems a bit too extreme if you ask me. Another complaint I have is that boss characters have a reach that is way too ridiculous. Here's one part of the final boss fight. This dude is pulling off some dowsome moves with a couple of syringes, and he'll just keep spamming that attack till the sun comes down. Dr. D, more like Dr. Dick. In any case, I guess there isn't a big learning curve here other than learning how to pull off special moves and maybe making use of characters that are able to fire projectiles. So I'd say 7 points. So did I enjoy this game? Well, mostly yes. I liked the setting right from the start and thought the characters looked cool, especially Buffmaster Miller here, and felt the game to be very enjoyable. The fact that you can unlock new characters alone was a major part for me to continue playing. I wanted to see how many people I could unlock and how they would play, but after a while, when regular enemies took longer and longer to beat, I felt my enthusiasm drop a bit. Being stuck on one screen because of one character that takes way too many hits and also keeps walking off screen became a drag. I wanted to fight more people, but didn't want to spend an eternity on them. I would have preferred to fight 8 people at once instead of 2 guys who have the health value of 8 people. Also, the final boss was a pain too, because not only did you have to fight Dr. Dickhead, you also had to fight his bioweapon. So suddenly you have 2 enemies with massive health bars, and both are able to pull off long-reaching attacks. Just fantastic. I doubt that anyone is able to get past this fight without losing at least 1 life. While this fight left a sour taste in my mouth, the rest of the game was enjoyable enough for me to admit that I liked it a whole bunch, and would even consider it a favorite of mine. I would say 8 points to enjoyment. Now, having gone through all those categories, let's count the points and see what the total is.
Right here is the best black athlete in the world! Pistol! Pez Watley, my brother!
What? What are you doing?
And there we have it. Big Fight, Big Trouble in the Big Atlantic, Big Ocean. A big game that I would consider a big hidden gem amongst the beat-em-up big-em games. I would like to say there's more games we can look at by Tatsumi, but this was the last arcade game they made. In total, Tatsumi made 9 arcade games before they quit the arcade business and decided their focus should be placed on creating novelty machines, like palm readers and on the production of sticker printing. I'd say this is a strange development, but looking at other companies such as SNK and Konami, I'm not surprised. Now, when are we getting that SNK vs. Konami vs. Tatsumi slot machine game, though?